It has been a roller coaster couple of years. And yes, I'm talking about GPU prices. They kept telling us that it's gonna go down, then it bounces right out almost immediately. Frankly speaking, you gamers are probably tired of waiting and want a temporary fix for your gaming needs. Which is why today we're gonna be reviewing something that might just be the right fit for you if you wanna build a PC today and don't want to wait for the scalper GPU prices to come down. I'm talking about this Ryzen 5 5600G that comes with integrated Vega graphics. The Ryzen 5 5600G has been released for quite some time now. In fact, it has been lurking in pre-built OEM PCs since April 13, but has only recently risen into our attention when it hit the shelves for the DIY market on August 5th. Now, this review is definitely a little bit late compared to some of the videos that are already floating around in YouTube. So I'm gonna break it down based on the three different groups of consumers that I think that this APU could be perfect for. And they are, number one, competitive players. Number two, people are just waiting for the GPU prices to come down and need a stopgap of a CPU for their PC. And number three, we are looking for those people who love those chili padi PCs that are very tiny but can do everything. An IDX build for your casual gaming, media, and also content creation needs. We're gonna test this APU based on those three different applications, as well as do some RAM tests to see what kind of memory speeds or timings you need to get the optimum performance out of the iGPU. Wow, what's happening with my Gina Tang today? So feel free to skip to whichever part of this video that you find interest in based on the timestamps below. Without further ado, let's get cracking. The retail unit of the Ryzen 5 5600G is priced at 1,239 ringgit or $259 and comes with that familiar Rift Stealth cooler with no RGB, so feel free to buy a third-party cooler if you want disco lights. In terms of specs, the Ryzen 5 5600G, like all the other 5000 series APUs, come with a Zen 3 architecture, much like the Ryzen 5000 series CPUs. In fact, it looks very similar to the Ryzen 5 5600X with the same 6 cores, 12 threads at the same 65W TDP. But being an APU, it does come with an integrated but older Vega iGPU, not RDNA, with 7 CUs. Also, compared to the 5600X, we are also getting half the L3 cache at 16 MB and a lower boosted clock at 4.4 GHz, but a higher base clock of 3.9 GHz. All that at a slightly lower price point. Also, like all Zen 3 processors, the 5600G chip has the same upgraded DDR4 3200 interface, which will definitely help gaming performance with the integrated GPU. We're gonna definitely put this to the test, so stay tuned for that. Other than that, the 5600G has 24 lanes of PCIe Gen 3 connectivity compared to the 24 lanes of PCIe 4.0 as found on Ryzen 5000 series CPUs. And this is where there could potentially be some bottlenecking when it comes to higher end GPUs, as well as being a deal breaker for people who need that PCIe Gen 4 connectivity. Before we move on to the test, here are the specs to our test bench. For our first category of consumers, we have competitive gamers. And for this application, we're not gonna be looking at super high quality settings. Instead, we're gonna be looking at 720p or 1080p gaming in competitive titles like Valorant to see how many FPS we can squeeze out of this APU. For this round of tests, we are pitching the 5600G with the iGPU against itself as a pure CPU with a GT 1030 to see how its iGPU actually performs against a lower end discrete GPU. If the GT 1030 outshines the iGPU in the 5600G, then I would make an argument that you should pair the GT 1030 with a lower end CPU like the Intel Core i5-10400F instead, which should cost about the same or less. Surprisingly, the Vega 7 integrated GPU in the 5600G crushes the GT 1030, which is a discrete GPU, mind you, with an 11-25% lead. In a newer title like Valorant, it beat the GT 1030 by a whopping 37.5%, even giving us more than 60 FPS in 1440p with all the settings cranked up. Next, we are considering people who are looking for a stopgap CPU while waiting for GPU prices to normalize, which is never. Anyways, we want to see how the Ryzen 5 5600G compares to the slightly more expensive 5600X from a pure CPU standpoint, especially when paired with a higher-end GPU like our RTX 3080. This is where we're potentially going to discover any CPU bottlenecks when using the 5600G temporarily, only to add on a discrete GPU in the future. In synthetic benchmarks, the 5600X with twice the amount of cache and consistently higher clock speeds definitely has a small advantage over the 5600G in CPU scores. Graphics scores are also a little bit higher than the 5600G. However, given the price difference as well as the inclusion of that integrated GPU with the 5600G, the price to performance ratio between the two is actually not that far off. Also, we added the Ryzen 5 3600 because this CPU is still pretty readily available in case you're considering it as well. A similar pattern can be observed in gaming benchmarks, where you'll see higher frame rates in lighter threaded games like Valorant. However, the performance gap quickly drops when you have titles like Red Dead Redemption 2 or Doom Eternal that have more of a GPU bottlenecking or a better multi-threaded utilization. Again, in productivity tasks for content creation and 3D work, the 5600X is going to perform slightly better across the board. In lighter threaded tasks like Premiere Pro or Photoshop, the 5600X is going to take a bigger lead by about 9-10%, but when it comes to heavier multi-threaded work in After Effects, Resolve, or even Blender, this lead drops down to a meager 1-5%, which correlates with my initial thoughts that the 5600G is the perfect stopgap processor, especially for content creators, but for that we have to move on to the next part where we see how it performs by itself.
If you're one of those ITX PC enthusiasts that believe that size doesn't matter and want to build a shoebox PC that can do a little bit of everything, including content creation such as 4K video editing, here are a series of tests for you. We pitched the 5600G against itself with a GT 1030 in Doom Eternal and Shadow of the Tomb Raider, as well as the same Puget test that we did before.
Time Spy shows us that while the CPU power of the 5600G has drastically improved over the last gen 3400G by about 71%, the iGPU improvement is a pretty small one. In gaming, while the 5600G definitely beats the GT 1030 in higher end titles, it seems that outside of competitive esports titles, you're going to have to lower your expectations or, well, lower the in-game settings to get playable FPS. Productivity tasks is where the 5600G shines. In both the Puget Premiere Pro and DaVinci Resolve tests, the GT 1030 actually failed to run for us, while the 5600G with its integrated GPU gave us some respectable numbers. I could in fact see myself building a tiny ITX build as an on-the-go editing PC when I'm traveling to Computex, for instance.
Also, I know this video is a little bit late, but it did give us more time to gather data for an updated look at the Ryzen 5 5600G. I especially want to find out how much memory speeds and timing affect the performance of that integrated GPU. Shout out to Eber from Hardware Canucks for covering this topic extensively, so feel free to check out his video in the links below. We did a little test of our own to verify his findings, and this is what we found. Frequency is a lot more important than memory timing when it comes to the iGPU, but while that is true, looser timings do negatively impact the overall CPU performance. However, I still find that it is counterproductive to buy the most expensive and fastest RAM kits out there, considering that the 5600G is designed to be a cost-effective option or as a stopgap while you wait for GPU prices to come down.
I give the Ryzen 5 5600G a very super scalper's boogie mampus cheap buy, 9/10. This score is based on the three categories of consumers that I mentioned before. Number one, for competitive players, I give it a 9/10 because I think it's very good value for competitive titles like Valorant. Number two, when it comes to being a stopgap CPU while you wait for GPU prices to drop, I think that it has
pretty good price to performance ratio, very close to the 5600X. But if it was a little bit cheaper, I would have given it a 9 out of 10. Number 3, for your ITX Workplay PC, I think that it should get a 9 out of 10 because it's pretty all-rounded for casual gaming as well as content creation, especially when it comes to 4K video editing. When you pair it with something like 16GB of RAM or more and a fast storage. So I kind of rounded it up because I think that a product like this makes a lot of sense, especially when it comes to the current GPU market. Some reviewers are actually suggesting that instead of buying these new APUs, that we go for a lower end CPU and pair it with a secondhand GTX 1060. But honestly, I think this is a little bit disingenuous because then you can suggest that people get a secondhand Ryzen 5 5600X for the same price as this APU and then go on from there. I mean, it's never gonna end, right? If you thought this video is awesome, you know what to do. Leave a comment down below if you have any questions regarding the 5600G and I will try my best to reply to you there, also in the comment section later. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the notification bell, and also follow us on Facebook and Instagram. And if you want to be more supportive, you can always consider to be a supporter on Facebook so that you can see my face more and I can see you more on Facebook. See, I so pandai cakap, you still don't support me, man.